Marvel's Avengers are actually losing players. Valorant introduces a new character and Apex Legends has nerfed a legend. Hey, what's up people? Welcome to a new video of Gamer Connect. I'm Gaming Madness and you guys are watching top gaming news of this week. Marvel's Avengers that came out on August had a good initiative, but its lackluster gameplay made it boring for many players. The campaign might have worked out, but the multiplayer seemed like you're playing the same things over and over again. It's as if you're playing the same single player game over and over and over again. For example, for me, Max Payne 2 was that game that I kept on playing over and over again because I didn't have any other games, so... Now people are losing interest in Marvel's Avengers, and according to Steam charts, there are less than 1,000 players in the game. Less than 1,000. People are having a hard time trying to find matches and they have to fight with bots, and these bots, well, they don't do anything. They will fight, they will definitely fight, but they won't complete any objectives. You have to do it by yourself, which is very annoying. Crystal Dynamics promised that more characters will be coming, but there is no official release date yet. The studio head, Scott Amos, said that in the next few weeks, there will be a new Warzone-type mission, Tachyon Rifts, a new outpost like Hellcarrier or Ant-Man Base that will serve as a hub for future missions. Even with this statement, he didn't reveal when all of this is coming. They also announced new heroes to be coming soon, and that is Hawkeye, which is great. But now that the game has been released and it's already been 2 months, where is that character? Where is Hawkeye? We still don't have a particular date for that character to come into the game. Working on this live service game is great, but balancing on everything can be hard. With the game having not so many things to be excited about, as the missions are pretty linear, the upgrade system makes zero difference apart from getting some increase in the numbers and no physical appearance change at all. And grinding for all of that makes not much of a sense, and for many, it is a waste of time. Even though the game is priced for $60, having characters that have not yet come, they will be coming in the future, and then having battle pass for every single character by paying certain amount of money makes not much of a sense. But Scott Amos still believed that people will return to the game as they add new content and improve the game. Well, I like their confidence, but they have to either improve a game a lot or add certain more interesting things so that players can come back to the game. What do you guys think of Marvel's Avengers? Are you guys playing the game? Are you guys enjoying it? Let me know all of that in the comments below. Even though the Indian servers for Valorant will still take some time to be officially live, but in the meantime, there are much more content coming to the game. Valorant Act 3 will start tomorrow with a new map named Ice Box, featuring ziplines and 2 bomb sites, and designed to emphasize skirmishes, sharp aim, and adaptive gameplay, according to the level designer. He says that each site is intended to have complex combat spaces and with plenty of cover and verticality, and there are also zip lines, which makes the game even more faster. Well, according to him at least. Along with that, there will be a new character named Sky. I'm sorry. She is a new healer in the game and she has a lot of magical pets. There's a lot of them. She can deploy a Tasmanian Tiger that, when triggered, will explode in a concussive blast that damage enemies who are directly hit by it. She also has a guidable hawk that will flash and blind the enemies and will play a hit confirmation if anywhere within the range and the line of sight when it goes off. Sky's ability is to use Trinket to heal all the allies within the range and the line of sight, but unfortunately, she cannot heal herself. Her ultimate enables her to send 3 seekers who will find out the 3 closest enemies and near sight them, obscuring their vision. I think this ult is very much powerful and I believe people will have a lot of fun when they get to play her. This new character will come out on October of 27th, but before that there is a new battle pass featuring a lineup of cosmetics including gun buddy charms. Quite interesting buddy charms there. Are you guys excited about this new map, a new battle pass, and this new Act 3, including a new character? Let me know in the comments below. Genshin Impact had a lot of success and is the biggest international Chinese title ever, with 17 million downloads in only 4 days. Now, the developer will be releasing a series of updates. The first of one will be Update 1.1, which will come in November 11th, and the second major update will come on December 23rd. The update 1.1 won't be that big. There will be a feature to lock items and equipments so they aren't actually used as fodder to power up other items. Players will also be able to use food and medicine without opening the actual inventory, which is amazing. And another new item will be added to find out the hidden chests and collectibles in case you missed it. although this next thing isn't in the update, but apparently the developer will allow players to customize the controls and rebind the keys. The update will also add a new event called the Unreturned Star, but it isn't clear what activities there will be. Update 1.2 will be exciting, but not much has been talked about, but it did say that Dragonspine Mountain will be added in the game, giving players a complete new region to explore. I mean, nothing more has been explained about how big the region will be, how much more puzzles will there be, will the puzzle in this region similar to all the puzzles that are there in every other regions. Update 1.3 will include the Lantern Rite Festival, which has a series of activities associated with it, and that's all. I guess the closer we will get to these updates, the more information we will get to know what these updates are about. But in fairness, it's really awesome to see that they're adding these updates and trying to improve the game as much as they can for the players to enjoy the game and add more content. Genshin Impact is very similar to that of Zelda Breath of the Wild, but still different, and it's very fun to play and very addicting as well. The most important thing is that this game is free for all. Play on your mobile or PC or even PS4. Well, go ahead and download right now. It's free for all and it's not that big of a size, so you won't be disappointed. Well, last week, Apex Legends added a new update with a new game mode, new skins and more, including a crossplay beta which has this computer icon besides your name. So now you can finally play with the PS4 buddies, and it's something that people have been asking for a long time, and they finally got it. But with this update, someone else got nerfed, and that someone else is Wraith. Previously, Wraith had this Naruto type of run, which gave players some kind of advantage. Well, now that has been taken away, so she runs like any normal character would run. To be honest, it looks very weird because after what, 6 seasons, she is running like a normal person? It is very weird. I understand why they had to nerf her run, because people were taking advantage of that. It was very hard for people to actually shoot her down, but with her running animation changed, people can now take her down actually a little bit faster and quicker. According to the devs, this was the only way to balance things up instead of taking some of her abilities away, but maybe later down in the line they can add some more power to her abilities if this running style proves balanced enough. There was also a small tease about the next thing that the game is going to add, but they will be adding a real-time damage meter, which is on the list according to the design director as he answered a fan on Twitter. This feature will allow players to track the progress towards damage badges, and it seems to be getting a lot of support from the Apex community. Also, hopefully by the end of this year, we will get Apex Legends on Steam. That's another thing that these guys are trying to work towards, to release that game on Steam. And when that happens, I believe a lot more players will get into the game. According to an interview with Behavior Interactive, the studio behind Dead by Daylight, the plans for the next gen consoles were asked, upon which they said that for now they have planned on 4K resolution and 60 FPS on PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X. There will also be ray tracing added, but not on launch. According to the product manager, they want to take some time to implement this so that they don't have any negative impacts on gameplay, and apparently, ray tracing is also coming to PC. They're also planning to add some of those PlayStation features such as haptic feedback from DualSense and adaptive triggers, but for now, they're not going to add that. At least for now, they want to focus on a smooth gameplay experience for PlayStation 5 users as well as Xbox Series X users. Speaking of PlayStation 5, according to the blog post of PlayStation, 99% of PlayStation 4 games will be playable in PS5. Those who get the digital version of PlayStation 5, you can only play the digital versions of the PlayStation 4 games, not the physical version. But if you have the physical version of PlayStation 5, you can play both digital as well as physical versions of PlayStation 4 games. PSVR is also compatible, but you will be needing the PS camera for PlayStation 4 and PSVR headset, of course. Unfortunately for us, it will take time before PlayStation 5 can actually launch on India, but I have my hopes up that it will come soon. Well, moving on towards Spooktober, The Medium, which is the next game by Bloober Team, is coming out on December 10th, which is sad because they could have released this game on Halloween because it's a horror game, but it's fine because they're actually releasing the game because for a long time it was still Holiday 2020. I'm actually very much excited to see what this game will be all about, and I cannot wait. Well, that will do for this episode of Top Gaming News. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, make sure to press that like button and comment down below what you think about this very episode. And also don't forget to subscribe to Gamer Connect to watch more content coming out every single week. My name is Gimin Madness, and I get to see you guys in the next one. Hope you guys have a good day and take care of yourselves.